Okay, in this video, we're going to show you how to set up your very own Google Fax service. It's super easy. It only takes a couple of minutes. So let's go ahead and get started. So what exactly is a Google Fax service? The Google Fax service is the process of sending a document to a fax number or receiving it by way of your Gmail account. Simple enough. So let's get into it step by step. Let's talk about what we have to do so that you can get your faxes sent out in the next couple of minutes. Step one, you're going to need to get yourself a Gmail account or just log into your Gmail account. Since you're looking for a Google Fax service, I'm guessing that you might already have a Gmail account, but just in case you don't, let's go ahead and take a look. Okay, so you're going to go to gmail.com and your first step is to create an account. And you would enter your name here. And then you would pick something for your username that's not already taken. So for me, it might be Matt Gerchow 123. So then you would enter your password, the rest of your information, their CAPTCHA, and then you would confirm the account either through a text message or some other means. It's really no big deal. It only takes a few seconds. So now that you've got your Gmail account, let's move on to step two. Step two, you're going to be selecting an online fax servicing company to handle the back-end fax operation. Now, there's a lot that goes into being able to send a fax. It has to be done through what's called the FOIP, which is Fax Over Internet Protocol. If we jump over to Google Fax Service here, you'll see that RingCentral has an offer. They also are offering a 30-day trial. All you have to do is click there and you can get signed up. You see you've got a 30-day trial. Only takes a few minutes to get going. If you want to, you can pause this video now and go ahead and complete that. All right. Now that you've got your online fax servicing company set up, let's go ahead and jump over to Gmail. And I want you to go ahead and click the Compose button. And I'm going to do that here live for you as well. Once you're logged into Gmail, all you do is click on the Compose button, and that's going to open up a brand new email, and that's going to take us on to our next step. In our next step, you're going to enter your fax number using the following format. I've got a sample number here, which is 206-555-3434 at rcfax.com. Now, the rcfax.com is kind of what makes the magic here. So let's go ahead and jump over to Gmail and do that. I'm going to go ahead and enter my fax number, which is 941-209-1327 at rcfax.com. The next step along the line is to enter any text that you would like on the cover sheet and then attach any document that you would like to fax. So I'm going to type into the subject line here, "Hey Charlie, check this out. I think you'll find it interesting." And then I want to go ahead and attach a file that's going to be my actual fax. So I'm going to open this up. Here's a small document that I was working on earlier. Okay, now that that's attached, let's go ahead and move on to our next step. Step six, you're going to click Send. As you can see, there's really not all that much to sending a Google fax, so let's go ahead and do that. Okay, that's easy enough. We just click Send, and now our fax has been sent. We can see the message here, and now I'm going to go ahead and pause this video until we receive that fax. I actually received the faxes for 941-209-1327 right into my Gmail account as well. So I'm going to pause the video, and we'll be right back. Okay, resuming the video here, we see that RingCentral has sent us a message that our fax has been sent successfully, and then they've also sent us a message here with the actual fax in it. You can see that the attachment is included. I'm going to go ahead and click on that. And scrolling down here, something that's notable to point out using RingCentral versus some of the other systems is that you can view a PDF right here attached versus having to open up and look at something like an EFX viewer or some other type of software product. This uses Adobe, which is the viewer is built right into Google as well. So I'm going to click on View. Okay, and so you'll see here at the bottom, here's the comments that I put in the subject line. And then scrolling down, there is the document that I was working on. Pretty straightforward. And that's all there is to sending and receiving a Google Fax. If you haven't gotten started yet, go ahead and head on over to googlefaxservice.com and get started right now so you can start sending faxes. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in another video.